Hello everyone, I'm Dohun, and today I'm going to give a speech about the meritocracy trend. Michael Sandel's book, The Training of Merit, struck people all around the world, making us think about the other side of the merit system. Is the meritocracy system working correctly? If not, what are the improvement measures and alternatives to it? These questions, which people look for granted or hadn't even ever thought about before, struck people around the world. Now I would like to introduce the concept of the meritocracy trap based on the book, The Training of Merit. And then I will look at other experts' perspectives and lastly introduce my opinion on this problem. In the book, The Training of Merit, Michael points out three main points on meritocracy. Firstly, he remarks on the contingency. No longer how much I work hard, I cannot be a basketball player like LeBron James. And this inherited talent itself is totally random. The probability of the environment you have been born in also matters too. If LeBron James was born in an ancient society, he would be able to earn that much wealth and honor. This means that one's success isn't entirely thanks to one's effort. Secondly, he talks about the disruption of common good. In a society where meritocracy is prevalent, meritocracy works as a kind of a medium to justify their achievement. For example, someone would think his amount of property or the academic background was completely only based on his hard efforts. This makes him conceited. On the other hand, the poor would think their social status is only their fault. According to meritocracy, it was all because they didn't work hard and didn't put in effort. They will feel relative deprivation. Therefore, intense meritocracy will make the rich conceit and the poor despair. Which is against the common good. Lastly, meritism is no longer working as a ladder to raise people's social status. People who are born in wealthy families not only get money from their parents, but also a better learning environment with greater lessons. This enables the hereditary of academic ability. Not all people agree with Michael Sandel's idea. The dissertation, Can We Overcome Competencialism in Capitalism? The author says that the capitalism society, meritism is necessary. According to the free market principle, the one who has higher competitiveness earns more. In this progress, people earn the motivation to work, which is the driving force of the economy. Others say that it is a matter of whether the operation of it or the misoperation of it is a problem. The side who says the misoperation of it is a problem contends that meritocracy itself has no problem, but it's misworking. So we need to eliminate its side effects by making legislations. On the other hand, the side that says the operation is a problem says that the meritocracy itself has a problem. Since competencialism essentially proposes competition, discrimination, and inequality, it is not an alternative to inequality, but serves to justify discrimination and solidify inequality. So far, we look at several experts' idea of meritocracy. I think that there isn't any perfect solution to this problem. Social and economic inequality is a chronic feature of capitalist society. Everybody's starting point differs from being born. Every person's inner talent, home environment, and home's economic wealth differs. So pursuing complete equality while leaving the capitalism system intact is self-contradictory. We need to understand the assumption that the same starting line cannot be met and reduce excessive inequality through correction of results. Tolerating infinite differences in compensation according to the performance would only deteriorate the social gap between people. We need to decrease this excessive gap so as to make a better society for everybody to live. I think that every one of us should look back to our society, whether our society is measuring the amount of effort correctly, and how much result can it reflect the amount of effort. Thank you for listening to my speech.